2 weeks before September 20th, Puerto Rico already got hit pretty hard by Hurricane Irma. Subsequent to Hurricane Irma, 2 weeks later, was Hurricane Maria.
Hurricane Maria made landfall in my hometown of Yabucoa. For 7 days, I didn't reach my family. I couldn't reach my family.
I was there in the island with Hurricane Hugo, with Hortense, with the rest of the hurricanes. But this one, you just felt the power of it. How the house was like shaking. Even when your house is in concrete, it was scary just for an adult. Just imagine a kid feeling that noise, that pounding in your door.
But the people of Puerto Rico, I think, had no idea that it was going to hit as hard as it did, and it was devastating.
I went to Puerto Rico 2 or 3 days later with Governor Cuomo. When we landed and we got off the plane, my eyes couldn't believe what I saw.
Millions of people without power, without water and food, with their homes destroyed. What we saw that followed was even worse, which was the longest blackout in American history.
It was a complete war zone.
Everything was shut down. Nothing worked. It was total chaos.
It was the first time in my life I saw the island completely brown. And you know, Puerto Rico is an island, so we have a rainforest. We've always been green. So I never experienced that.
And in my mind, I feel that Puerto Rico was set back 50 years.
The official death toll was around 70, 76, but we know the unofficial, as determined by several key universities, was more like 4,900.
People died because the ambulances couldn't show up on time, because there was not good food, because people drank water that was terrible. But number two, because the response of the American government was not what it should be.
No one can imagine how difficult it is to see seniors, all people alone, without their families, struggling, without a home, without a roof, without somebody that can take care of them during an emergency situation.
And we saw a lot of people who had barely any means help those with nothing.
I have never been prouder of the people of Puerto Rico as when I see them respond to this very harsh, tragic moment that Maria has made the people of the island confront.
The people were not thinking about themselves. They were going, how to help? Nobody asks you, but you will see everybody, how can we help? How can we move that tree? What do you need? Do you get water? Do you get gasoline for your generator?
When there wasn't any food, they would put their resources together and they would like open up a community kitchen. You know, Doña Maria had la cafeteria de la comunidad.
We also saw the diaspora, part of what I'm from as a Florida Rican, come down to the island with supplies, with water, with food, with clothing, with medical supplies.
Because that's what we do as Puerto Ricans. Our extended family is our first responder.
Well, you'd see over and over the phrase Puerto Rico se levanta, which means that we'll lift ourselves up. People were proud that they would be able to rise above all this.
I've been amazed to see and experience the struggle that they have gone through and how difficult this recovery is going to be. But yet, I know that they will come together, they will plan together, and we must make sure that the federal government provide the resources to help American citizens in Puerto Rico recover and rebuild.
But I have great faith in the ability of Puerto Ricans to come together and live through it and rebuild. They will rebuild a new Puerto Rico, and I hope that Puerto Rico is stronger structurally than the last one, because we're living in a different age.
The U.S. Congress passed a relief package that it will provide $18 billion for the rebuilding of Puerto Rico.
$1.5 billion additional for HUD, for CDBG funds, again, housing and other areas of economic development. That's not gonna be enough.
Puerto Rico is still in crisis. And so we have a responsibility to our fellow Americans to make sure we don't let Puerto Rico fall by the wayside. We know it'll take both teamwork of the citizens on the island, the Puerto Rican government, the United States government, and also many states to help out. But we know of the resiliency of our people. We know that if we work together, we can accomplish this. We just need the will and the funds to do it, and we will do it together.
I wasn't born on the island of Puerto Rico, but this is a special place. There's something in my veins, there's something in my spirit, because there's something special about the place where your mom and your dad were born.
Those of us that left Puerto Rico a long time ago, that came here for whatever reason, never stopped being Puerto Ricans.
We will be in this journey together. Puerto Rico will be rebuilt to last for generations to come.
We're always part of you, and you're part of us, and we're not going to forget that.